Today we're going to work on a little bit of weathering. We're going to use washes, a little bit of airbrush and everything. We're going to be working on several different cars, just so you can see the different effects on each type of car and color. This is anything anybody can do at home. So we'll get these out of the way. What I normally start out with is I get these little Dixie cups. And I fill them up, if you can't see it in here, but there's a little edge up to about that level with a little bit of alcohol. Alcohol evaporates a little bit faster than water. I think it works a little bit better. Then what I do is I start by adding the colors and the mixes. I usually start with something like oily black. It's kind of a gray. It looks good. I usually follow it with some sort of rust colored. Like that, a rust or a brown or a dirt or something like that, usually followed up with. And then when I'm finally done, I'll either use a little bit of mix of dirty black or tarnished black. Thing about weathering is you gotta remember that a little bit goes a long way. You can always add more. You can take off stuff too, but it's much easier to add than to remove. Make sure your paints are mixed well. That's another important thing to pay attention to. And if you think it needs a little bit of more, weathering on it, you're probably good. I would stop at that point, run with it for a while, and see about adding more later on. So what I use on my paints is I have this little mixer, purchased it from Micromart. Awesome little device. Pretty much like a drink mixer. Just put it in, stir it up a little bit, tap off the excess, put it in the cup, let it rip, and then just wipe down. Great little device. If you don't have one, suggest to do one. It beats the old-fashioned way of shaking them, and then some people that are really in the paints get upset. So this might make you angry. Don't do this. It makes people angry. So since we're starting out with the base of the weathering, it doesn't take much. I usually just take a little mixing straw, drop it in, just add the couple drops in. That's it. That's all it needs. In fact, that might even be a little too much, but we're going to go with that. Another thing I kind of like to do sometimes is I like to pre-wet my cars before I start weathering them a little bit. It's just a little bit of alcohol, same thing. Helps it stuff flow. And all the stuff that you can use is just basic hobby junk. So we'll start with this car right here. I just basically wipe it down with alcohol, kind of pre-soak it up. Nothing hard here. Just wipe it down. Get the ends. Then all I do is I just take my little bit of weathering solution. Hopefully it's not too dark, and just let it flow down, just like that. That's all it is. Run it across the roof. Move these out of the way a little bit. Same thing right here, just run it across. It just kind of flows down, just like real life. Run it across, get the ends. The ends are black, so it's not going to take much. Some people comment you got to wear gloves and everything like that. You're going to get dirty. All that, my basic setup right there. That's a starter. And when you're done with that, that actually looks really good just in its own. So I'll set it off to dry and I'll continue doing the rest of the cars. These cars here, in another segment, I'll show you how the re-decal stuff and everything. These are coated with dull coat on them. So when you alcohol and dull coat, make a funny kind of mixture. Gives them a different effect. But like I said, just, and I'm using the other brush. It doesn't really matter. Just pre-soak them, get them nice and wet. Get the ends. And come back with our base weathering color. And just in the darker cars, it doesn't show up as well. Hit the ends. That's it. Just like nature. When it rains on the car, it just drips down the side. Set it off to the side. Do the next one. You can see this goes pretty quick. There's no need to be neat about it. It's weathering, it's dirty. It's a dirty type of deal. Just slop it on. If you run out of your weathering mix, just add more of it. Just let it run down the side. Paint the whole car if you want. Doesn't really matter. With weathering, you kind of do it in layers. It looks better with, you know, two or three colors look natural versus a single, even a double color kind of gives it away. Because in real life, stuff varies in color. Just slap it on. Go to the next one. Pre-soak it. So there's nothing wrong with being messy about it, because that's what it is. This one here, putting a little thicker on the roof. Run it down the sides. Let's let it do its thing. A lot of people have pictures up. You can find good pictures to copy. People on eBay are going to shoot me for this, but look in the slide section. People always have nice pictures of trains that they're going to, actual real trains that they're photographed. But just for reference photos, it works really well. And the final one. Same thing with this car. I re-decaled it earlier today. Another segment. I'll show you what I did. But it's got dull coat on it to protect the decals. Alcohol and dull coat kind of turn a foggy color when mixed. Looks like you've ruined stuff. But in the end, you just spray it one more time and it turns out. Looks really good. Same thing, just run it along the top. See how it kind of flows? Let it flow down the side here a little bit. Normally, I don't let this stuff dry in between time before I go to the next color, but I'm gonna let it dry this time.